But anyway, it's time for PT. We're playing it. That theme is glorious. Yeah, I love the Dark Souls 3 theme. Watch out. The gap in the door. It's a separate reality. The only me is me. Are you sure the only you is you? Someone's been through this hallway and back into this room a lot of times. My voice, can you hear it? This sign, can you read it? I'll wait forever if you'll just come to me.
Thank you. You got fired, so you drowned your sorrows in booze. She had to get a part-time job working a grocery store cash register. Only reason she could earn a wage at all is the manager liked how she looked in a skirt. You remember, right? Exactly 10 months back.
Watch out. The gap in the door. It's a separate reality. The only me is me. Are you sure the only you is you? I like everybody freaking out about my mic being muted. This is not the kind of game that feels right to commentate over. I just want everyone to kind of enjoy it for what it is. Queen, thank you for the gift sub to Lisa is Hot. Mushbrains Media, thank you for the sub earlier. I don't remember if I got you for that, but appreciate it. This is live. This is the part of PT that I'm not sure how to complete it without a microphone yet. Because I have no idea where my PS4 mic is. If I had a microphone, I could have finished this already. I don't have a command for it, Queen. I'm not worried about it. Thank you. I finished Book of Memories. Cheaterbot, thank you for the 169. Appreciate the tip. Thank you for the support.
Oh.
Alamira, thank you for gifting a sub to Celestial Moroku. Appreciate the support. No, I don't, Olvella. I mean, I have headphones and I have headsets, but they're all, like, studio headsets. It's not the type that I can plug into a PS4 controller. I'm not sure if that counts as two. I think the cycle resets when I get attacked by Lisa. Because that was just the 10 steps in one direction, one laugh. So that's just the first laugh again on a new cycle. Typically, yes, the solution is to use a microphone, but I don't have one. And supposedly this is still completable without one. It's just less consistent. What do you say on the mic if you have one? You say the name Jack. Sure, Queen. Because at this point, I'm just trying stuff that I know I've read about over the years. But I mean, even though I finished this a few times, I've never actually known 100%, like, consistently how to finish it, especially without a mic. If I had anything that could connect to the PlayStation 4 as a microphone, I would use it. I have nothing. think I'm dead again. Yeah, I've already been doing that, Queen. That's why I keep going back and forth between the radio, the mirror, and the phone. I'm getting the haunting, but not the laugh. Thank you. we'll just try a new cycle. So the 10 steps. Ten steps for the first laugh is pretty consistent. Just wait for the clock to chime midnight and take exactly 10 steps. First laugh is the easiest one. It's the next two that suck. So there's the 10 steps, first laugh. Yeah, Garsh. Everything's been translated. PT at this point has been completely data mined. Like, if you're curious what all the messages and all the different languages and all those different things if you're curious what all that stuff is, you can look it all up on silenthillmemories.net. Yeah, Lance McDonald figured out a lot of the later stuff on this. Like, cam hacking to figure out that Lisa's always on your back. She's always right behind you. Even during the times where she's not actively haunting you and you can't hear her. Even if you're leaning against a wall? Check it out, Cheaterbot. If I'm facing forward, I can push right up against a wall. Right? If I'm turned around, it only lets me back up so far. Like, you actually have further collision behind you because of Lisa being there. Same thing for the name that you say into the microphone. It's not just a word or a name with a J. It is specifically Jack. People data mined it. They looked up exactly the parameters, what the game is looking for. And it is the name Jack. Written out in the code in text. So yeah, this game's been totally data mined. At some point, I will plan on doing a full in-depth story playthrough. Not tonight. Not after 10 hours of Book of Memories. I just wanted to show off this game, but I don't know if I'll be able to actually finish it reasonably without a microphone. Yeah, I plan on doing a full in-depth at some point. Maybe this week we'll come back to this. I'll see if I can find my microphone, my PS4 mic. It's around here somewhere, but it's buried in a box, in a stack of boxes, and I have no idea where it is. Probably mixed in with a bunch of wires. You, Mike. I don't think that'll work because it runs through an adapter for the N64. Please laugh. I just can't get this second fucking laugh. The small headset that comes with the PS4, that's the one that I'm talking about, Psychosis, that is buried in boxes with a bunch of other wires. And I don't know exactly where it is. And no, Archangel, I do not have a P.O. box. I'm not comfortable giving out information for people to send me stuff. As said, I have a mic somewhere. I just don't have any idea where it is. And I'm not gonna go dig through a bunch of shit right now. I'm sorry. But I appreciate the thought. It sucks. I was really hoping I could finish this without a mic, like reasonably, but none of the other stuff I'm trying is really working for this other laugh. Hiromi's my only channel editor. But he's the only one who can change that stuff, Queen. I don't have commands and stuff set up to do it. You know, the thing that's frustrating about the whole microphone thing, they took the time to build the little speaker into your controller. They could have just as easily put a tiny little microphone along with it and just build it directly into the controller hardware. At least like a very, very simple one. Kind of like the DS microphone. Yeah, it wasn't quite that many shots. It was like 21, 22 shots of tequila over the course of like a 30-minute run. It was still pretty fucking ridiculous. That was quite a while back, though. That was like 2012, 2013, when I was doing Mario 64. Back when I still had like maybe 8 followers. Yeah, there's definitely no VOD for that. That's way before the days I even knew about VODs or setting up my channel to keep them or knowing anything about highlights. I don't even know if that was a feature on Twitch at the time. Yeah, I can't really drink anymore, Cheaterbot. Not like that. My health is considerably worse than it was in 2013. Yeah, that's all right, Fire Prince. I'm about to give up on this. This was just kind of a fun bonus thing. I'm enjoying the last, like, 2 hours of messing around with this than I did. Like, this is immensely more enjoyable than 10 hours of fucking Book of Memories. I needed this spooky hallway. Even if I'm not able to finish the whole thing, I needed this after Book of Memories. But yeah, I think that might be it. But either way, thanks you guys so much for enjoying the streams, enjoying the 72-hour Silent Hill marathon. Really appreciate everybody's support over the last several days. We started Friday night, and it's now Tuesday morning. Again, wouldn't have been possible without a ton of help and dedication from my good friends on Team Silent here on Twitch. An Eternal Enigma, Ravenheart, Maxi Lobes, UFO Techie, please be sure to follow all of them. They're all amazing people. Super entertaining streamers. And if you like Silent Hill and you like horror, all of us do a lot of that on our own solo channels, as well as our monthly events. Sometimes we do these marathons, sometimes we do group playthroughs, sometimes we'll have guests on to join us. All sorts of different stuff. Oh, I got text on the screen after that laugh. That was still just the ten step laugh. I'm not sure why I got text that time. Yeah, that's kind of the thing, Cheaterbot. Even though people have really, really dug into this game by now, playing it and actually trying to get certain things to trigger is not always so cut and dry. I was really hoping, since I got that text, I don't know. As said, all the stuff in this game's already been translated. SilentHillMemories.net. Just look at the PT section. You can see the entire list of every message that comes up in this game and its translation. I'm exhausted. I'm exhausted, and I'm not sure how to do this without a mic. So, I'm just gonna call it here. I'll do some more messing around with PT this week, I think. I'll dig out my mic. I'll go through and play it some offline. Try to find something a little more consistent. I'm going to talk with a few people in the Silent Hill speedrunning community that speedrun this game, because I imagine speedrunners are going to know how to do stuff in this game, like, more consistently. So maybe Plywood or somebody can help me out. Yeah, I think last few times where I've beaten this, I had my mic and I was able to do it no problem. So, if nothing else, once I find my mic, we can do that this week. And if I get it consistently to where I can play through it and everything, I'll plan on doing an in-depth PT stream. So that we'll go through it, we'll talk about solving it, we'll translate all the text. We'll talk about the story, because there is a story behind Lisa and her husband and their children or child or sink baby. We'll talk about the development and stuff behind it. What happened with Konami? What happened with Kojima? Where the project started? Where it was going? Why it ended, how it ended. We'll get into all that. This is a very, very short little game for a teaser. Just to show off that one Norman Reedus trailer for Silent Hills. But I've always held off on doing a story playthrough of it because I wasn't sure really how to format it. Because with every other game that I do a story playthrough of, it's a fully released game with a full plot and everything like that that I can talk about. This game, the plot is very, very small. There's not much to talk about when it comes to that. But talking about solving it itself, translating all the little clues, talking about the development and everything that happened with Konami and Kojima is it's one of those things that there's a lot to everything behind PT rather than kind of the story of PT itself. So I couldn't really think of a good way to format it. This week, we'll just jump into it. We'll just jump into it and cover as much as I can on it, answer as many questions about it as I can, and see what we can do with it. Yeah, on Twitter, I'm just at NubZombie. You can type !Discord for a link to the Discord. There will always be an announcement when I go live through Discord. I'll always tweet out whenever I'm going live. So It's one of those things. I just don't have a schedule. I don't have a consistent schedule for streaming, so gotta try to catch me when you can. But if you're following the channel, you should get a notification through Twitch. Make sure your notifications are turned on. A lot of times Twitch will disable them automatically for new channels that you follow, so you might have to manually go in and change that. Otherwise, as said, follow me on Discord, follow me on Twitter. You'll know when I'm going live. I'm probably going to take the next day, maybe two, off, because I'm pretty fucking exhausted, but still not feeling too great. But we'll see how I feel the next day or so, and I'll be back. And I plan on doing a lot of Silent Hill stuff for the next month or so, because we've got the rest of December and the first couple days of January, and then I'm going to be gone for a little over a week to Awesome Games Done Quick in Orlando. So if you watch Awesome Games Done Quick, you might see me on a couple of couches doing some commentary. I'm not running anything at the next one, so I won't be running anything myself, but I'll probably be sitting up there with some of my friends and stuff. But yeah, that's the plan. Those are the ideas going forward for the next couple weeks. Again, thanks everybody so much for coming by, enjoying the stream, enjoying the whole marathon. We'll be back together, of course. Everyone in Team Silent will get together and do some more events for everybody soon. We might do another one near the end of December, but with all the holidays and stuff going on, we might just hold off until we're all back from GDQ and all that good stuff. But yeah, thanks so much, everybody. Really, really appreciate all the support. It's why we do this. It's why we put up with games like Book of Memories and stay up so damn late. It's for you guys. All the love and support of the Silent Hill community has been amazing over the years. So really, really, I cannot say enough. I appreciate absolutely everything you guys do for me, even if it's just hanging out, enjoying the channel, saying a few kind words in chat. Like, it seriously means the world to us. So thank you all so much. I really, really appreciate it. Let's find somebody we can go raid. Someone we can raid. And then I'm going to bed. Yeah, I got my redemption on the Book of Memories run. That's a big one. I feel like I let people down during the last marathon, giving up on it. This time went much more smoothly. We powered through. Maxi, my friend Maxi, and fellow Team Silent member who's been part of this weekend marathon. Is streaming right now. He's doing some Silent Hill 4. He's playing a whole bunch of different games. He's doing his Maxi Games Done Quick marathon. So he's speedrunning a whole bunch of games. So if you didn't catch Maxi Lobes during the marathon, he's a great guy, amazing Silent Hill streamer, amazing streamer in general. He does a lot of variety, a lot of speedrunning. So definitely go and show Maxi some love. Drop him a follow if you're not already. Drop him a sub if you can spare it. It's all definitely appreciated. And thanks again. And I will see you guys all next time. Take it easy. Peace.